Hello, my name is Matt Swan, and I'm representing the Nova Scotia Power Makerspace. And I want to talk to you about how we've been able to use Javelin products to help a company called Rotofast. Now, if anyone is familiar with makerspaces, you know they come in all kinds of different varieties. Everything from focused on children in schools right up through to corporate entities that are developing new products in their own spaces. So what we are, we're a public-facing makerspace open to community members, and we have people come in, purchase membership, and have access to all sorts of tools and equipment that they wouldn't normally have access to. Typically, we tell people where their own tools, either at home or at work, where their tools stop. If we have extra, that's where we come in. We want to be an extension of what everybody else has already. So that's what the makerspace is. We're run by InnovaCorp. We have a corporate sponsor in Nova Scotia Power, and we have support from ACOA. We're here located in downtown Sydney, and we're here to help people with commercialization. We're here to help people become familiar with what's possible as far as making things. So let's dig in and we'll talk about how we've been able to help Rotofast. So Rotofast is a company that creates anchors for acoustic panels, mostly sound deadening. And what we want to talk about a little bit is a challenge that we faced with them, helped them through, as they needed to bring a prototype to market quickly. And so we needed to help them shorten their design time and iteration time. We needed to help them simplify the communication of that design off to their manufacturers. Process, we went through the typical upfront processes of product development, literally whiteboard and paper, looking at previous samples, and then we started moving towards SolidWorks. So with SolidWorks, obviously you're able to create the designs, and because of the way we're set up, those designs could be set to print and the next morning there would be something ready to go. And so then it's further design refinement, and finally you're left with a file that you can move on to manufacturing. The outcome on this one, I would say we took their typical time to functional prototype and reduced by months. That would be fairly safe to say. So let's look at that a little more. So Rotofast and their challenge. What happened? There was a new acoustic panel product hit the market, and a new opportunity for them to create a fastener, but it needed to happen quick. So they're looking at their possibilities of moving quickly on this, and they came to us. And we're really happy to be able to jump in and help them with it. Typically, they would have used more traditional methods of creating prototypes. So we had the privilege, the fun of not only helping them with it, but watching their excitement at seeing how quickly a new product could be turned into a proper prototype, tested, iterated, and pushed out into manufacturing. It was a great challenge. The process that we use, just to get into it a little more detail. So we're really thrilled to have SolidWorks available to us in the makerspace. It's a huge enabler. It's great to be able to design things on paper, and great to have some lower level CAD packages, but fabulous to have SolidWorks available. And we're teaching people how to use this, and even our member Rotofast, their employees have taken onto it and appreciate it, and are using the software for their own further developments in our space. So there's they're gaining abilities there that they never had before, not just solving a one-time problem. So yeah, we went through the process of initial designs, started moving it into SolidWorks, showing them how easy it was to make adjustments back up and down the feature tree and moving things until it looked right, looked like it might work. And then over to the Objet 30 Prime, drop those files in, and literally the next morning they've got their first piece, which was a little bit mind-blowing. And they took that first piece, looked at it, immediately saw they had iterations, changes that need to be made to it, sit right down at the in the CAD lab, make those changes on SolidWorks again, and put it right back in for the next morning. And so the iterations just happen so quickly to be able to get their parts done properly. Not only that, we're able to test various materials, see how they all worked with their own testing procedures to see what's going to work well, what's going to last, what's easiest to work with, manufacturability. So they're able to play around a lot with their materials. And followed the process through the multiple iterations until they were happy with it. It actually got to a point where they were making their own design changes on SolidWorks with very little help from us. They were setting up their own prints, very little help from us, and iterating until they got something that was just what they were looking for. And really valuable to be able to have that in a digital file. That file then can be shipped off to manufacturers, and there is no questions about exactly what the geometry looks like at that point. It's there, it's in the file, and so away that goes. So we were quite happy to be able to follow that process through and to help them move from an idea right through to a functional prototype that was tested and they had confidence in, and they were able to move it on to manufacturing. So let's talk a little bit about the outcome. We would say a very successful prototyping journey in the makerspace. They ended up with a quality product that passed all their testing with flying colors, probably better than they expected, and record development time. That was it was really something for them to see, something for us to see, how quickly that process went and how quickly there was something in hand that actually could be commercialized. Again, for them to be able to easily transfer the information to manufacturers for the quoting process, for tooling processes, whatever it might be. Here it is, here's the file, no drawings to interpret, although drawings go along with it for sure. But it's all there, it's all easy to interpret. And they move from there to quality manufacturing. Got their first parts off and tested them further, and away they went. And I'm really happy to be able to say that they had a successful market entry and wide market acceptance with that very, very quickly. So really, really happy with the outcome for Rotofast. Happy for the outcome of that for Makerspace, because that means a lot for us to be able to see how that was valuable. That's pretty well it. Here at the Nova Scotia Power Makerspace, we are really thankful for Javelin's support for their products. We're using them every day, teaching people the software, showing people the 3D printing capabilities. And here's to many more problems solved. Thank you very much.